How is your data protected when using Microsoft Copilot? And how do you get ready for it? Well, in the next few minutes, with Copilot for Microsoft 365, now more broadly available to organizations of all sizes, I'll unpack how you can securely take advantage of generative AI across Microsoft 365 app experiences. And I'll also go through the steps and resources to deploy it at scale. Now, if you're new to Copilot for Microsoft 365, it lets you use natural language prompts to interact with your organization's data and generate personalized content and responses with relevant insights that are unique to your work context. While you only see the generated response in your original prompt, behind the scenes, Copilot for Microsoft 365 interprets your request and, if necessary, will find information you have access to within your organization, from your work files sitting in SharePoint and OneDrive, as well as email and calendar via the Microsoft Graph, and it presents this information as additional context along with your original prompt to the large language model to generate a personalized and informed response. And even though none of this information is retained by the large language model, to securely take full advantage of generative AI, you can and should protect data at every stage, from the information contained in the user prompt to the information retrieved based on user access permissions, and the generated response itself, so that sensitive data is not inadvertently exposed when it shouldn't be. And the good news is controls for security and privacy over your data exist at every stage and will leverage the sensitivity labels and the corresponding policies that you've already got in place. Now, I'll start by showing you a couple of examples of the benefits of these data protection controls in action, and then I'll show you how to configure them yourself as an admin. In this case, I'm using Copilot in Microsoft365.com. I'll prompt it to list the key points from the Contoso purchase agreement. And the information that was retrieved shows the sensitive label for the document that it referenced. Now, to be clear, this is a file that I have explicit access to. And if I move over to the source document itself, you can also see the confidential sensitivity label was previously applied to it. So you saw how Copilot was able to inform me of the sensitivity of the document that it retrieved, all as part of its response. Now let's see how it works for content generation using Microsoft Word. So here, I'm going to prompt Copilot in Word to generate a confirmation letter that's based on the same purchase agreement with the sensitivity label that we saw before. And right after I reference that protected document, you'll see that with this shield icon here, it immediately recognizes this as a sensitive file. So now I'm going to hit Generate, and it will author a draft confirmation letter for the purchase agreement. Notice that when it's completed the confirmation letter, because the originating document has a confidential label, that same label is automatically applied to the generated file as shown in the information bar above the document. So the protection is inherited from the labeled source material. So as an admin, what are the steps then that it takes to protect your data? Well, it all starts by looking at your data access permissions and applying the principles of just enough access as well as least privilege for information across your entire data estate. And one of the first recommended steps that you can take as a Microsoft 365 administrator is to review SharePoint site access, prioritizing the sites containing the most sensitive information. Now here, you can start by looking for sites that have their privacy set to public, which means that all employees can discover and access them. And from there, you can require that site owners verify ownership as well as who should be members or visitors of these sites to limit access. Then, for content classification and labeling, one of the simplest controls to put in place is to classify files automatically saved to sensitive locations, as you can see here with the site owner controls for this document library. Now, that means that any content created in that location will get the label applied automatically, and corresponding policies can lock files down to the right people. Then for another easy test to see if you have sufficient access controls in place, you can use Search in Microsoft 365 even before you deploy Copilot to evaluate whether different users can discover and access sites or files that they should not have access to. The labels and classifications applied in those locations are configured and managed using Microsoft Purview. In fact, let me show you those controls as well as additional more advanced controls to protect your data using its auto-labeling and data loss prevention capabilities. The labels you apply in Microsoft Purview can automatically help you discover, limit the sharing radius, and apply encryption directly using policies. These can also be applied based on the content within the documents using data loss prevention or DLP policies with sensitive information types. So here, for example, I've started a DLP policy for personally identifiable information, and I've added a few sensitive information types already. And I can add even more with over 300 options here for things like banking numbers, addresses, identification types, tax information, and more. Additionally, using trainable classifiers, there are dozens of built-in document types that I can choose from, including source code, healthcare, HR, and more to auto-apply labels. Then moving on to device restrictions, I can also set up endpoint DLP policies to prevent users from copying sensitive data to their clipboards and then, for example, into unapproved AI assistant sites. Next, beyond data protection policies, let me explain how Copilot for Microsoft 365 activities can all be audited. Using content search in Microsoft Purview, all activity from Copilot for Microsoft 365 is discoverable, as you can see here. Retention policies can also be used to retain content in prompts and responses, and then retained based on your requirements. E-discovery is also supported for Copilot interactions, as you can see here with this case example. And communication compliance will likewise flag any content with established policy matches, like the one you see here for codename Obsidian. Of course, another important consideration is how data is processed and where it resides when using Microsoft Copilot services. Microsoft hosts and operates large language model instances in Microsoft data centers and will never use your data to train large language models. And data residency with Microsoft Copilot is consistent with Microsoft 365 and the locations where your data is already stored and processed today, which means that if your organization is based in the European Union, Copilot data is likewise stored and processed within the EU data boundary, like the rest of your data. Additionally, the Microsoft Copilot copyright commitment means that content generated using Copilot also comes with legal protections for Microsoft. Now, let's move on to how you can fine-tune policy settings and configurations for Copilot as an admin. And for that, we've added new controls in Microsoft 365's Admin Center, including links to many of the tools and concepts I've shown today. So here you can see the status of your Copilot assignments as well as the latest information on Copilot. Under settings, you can find what you need to manage Microsoft Copilot experiences found in Bing, the Edge browser, and in Windows, as well as deep links to many of the data security and compliance controls. Next, admin controls to submit feedback about Copilot for Microsoft 365 services on behalf of users. Then configurations for plugins and their permissions from the integrated apps page, as well as tenant-wide controls to allow the public web to be used as grounding data in Copilot for Microsoft 365 and more. Now with the right protections and configurations in place, you can take full advantage of generative AI and start deploying Copilot for Microsoft 365 services at scale. Now, this starts with ensuring that you've got the right Microsoft 365 services in place. And recently, this was expanded to organizations of all sizes with Microsoft 365 Business and Enterprise Suites, as well as faculty members for Microsoft 365 Academic Suites. Next, for Copilot capabilities to light up in Microsoft 365 apps, using the Microsoft 365 Apps Admin Center at config.office.com, you'll want to deploy either monthly enterprise, current channel, or current channel preview. From there, from the Microsoft 365 Admin Center under Setup, you can use the Get Ready for Microsoft Copilot for Microsoft 365 Setup Guide to configure any remaining items. And it walks you through many of the steps I just presented to prepare your organization. From here, you can even assign Copilot licenses to users and groups in scope for your deployment and send a welcome email to help them get started with Copilot. And with services deployed, a best practice for driving and improving adoption is to establish an internal community of Microsoft Copilot users. And the Copilot Hub at adoption.microsoft.com/copilot gives you additional resources by role to help users learn about and get the most from Copilot. So that was an overview of how security and privacy with Copilot for Microsoft 365 works and how you can get ready for Copilot in your organization. For more deep dives on other Microsoft Copilot tech, check out aka.ms/M365 Copilot Mechanics and keep checking back for the latest AI updates. Thanks for watching.